Hello friends, fans, and viewers everywhere, Shibby Swag here, and welcome to a new Let's Play of Power and Revolution 2019 Edition. Yay! You know, it's gonna be 2020 soon. Yay! This is a new game for me. I have seen some videos, I guess, on the previous Power and Revolutions, but it's gonna be my first attempt at it. So let's go ahead and get on to it. Game. Definitely gotta change my player. Can't have a new player. It's gotta be the Shib. Shibby Swag. Capital. Shibby Swag. Okay. Global menace status. I guess these are all scenarios. But we're just going to go with free mode. If I'm not mistaken, yes, we'll pick our country right here. We could be the United States. But where's the challenge? That almost seems a little too easy. Although being Donald Trump would be equally challenging, I imagine. But you know what? We're going to go with Israel. I'm going to rule the Middle East. Let's see here. We are a republic, parliament, conservatives, right. We've got 9 million people, so too many. Capital is Jerusalem. Climate, desert, something, yeah. Well, we got a pretty good GDP, $365 billion per our world share. Yeah, I've kind of like absolutely 80 nuclear weapons, so don't mess with us. Alright. Is there anything I want to change? Yes. Let me see here. I don't want to be an old guy. That guy's almost bald too right here. Let's at least get someone with some good hair. We're also going to rename you Shibe. Prime Minister Swag. Oh, that would be so funny. I sure as hell to hope my brand new microphone is recording everything. I'm in trouble. Okay. Warning, Geopolitical Simulator is the first of all games. The scenario and events taking place in it are political fiction. All names, photos, and places, but are fictitious. Yeah, okay. Sure they are. Alright, do not show this again. Elon Musk. You get up in the morning and think about the future is going to be better. It is a bright day, otherwise it is not. It's not. Sweet, there. See, first day in office, and we're already throwing parties for, you know, for the women. Glad, you know, grandma can get out there and not be hit on by some creepers. It's always good. All right, here we go. We are in the game. Maybe a few things to go over very quickly. Yeah. This blue is us. There's three primary colors. Got red, green, and white. Red, pretty much means they hate us. Darker the red, the more they hate us. So Libya hates us, even though they're kind of like reddish pink. Up here, you got Syria, Saudi Arabia hates us, you know, the usual suspects, Iran, Afghanistan, Pakistan. India likes us a little bit. Green is the ones that like us, and same concept, it's the same thing. The darker the green, they're friendly to us. Lighter means they're not, they're friendly, but they're still like, eh. We have a meeting with us, so I'm gonna pause the game real quick. White is just neutral, or gray, or which way you want to put it. It just means they just don't give a damn, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Now, let's see, we have a meeting request. I will accept your meeting. Alright, first and foremost, we got to take a look at our what people are saying. Information on CO2 capture. Prime Minister, in order to combat global warming. Oh yeah, I heard that was one in this one. We can reduce CO2 emissions, but it's also possible to look at CO2 capture as a solution. There are various types, and they would not only help lower emissions immediately, but also absorb some of the CO2 that's been accumulating in the atmosphere since the Industrial Revolution. It's a lot of CO2. Add that process that converts capture CO2 into usable hydrocarbon to use as fuel, and it becomes a source of renewable energy. These processes are still experimental, but investing in this sector and in research, then developing the necessary infrastructures, this could prove to be very effective in regards to our goals on global warming, as well as profitable on the economic level. Okay, you haven't changed objective reminder. Every year we decide on global CO2 emission worldwide. Prime Minister of the UN is now going to personally inform each leader. Predictions related to global warming and around the world, and especially the collective efforts implemented for reducing emissions of CO2. We are coming at the beginning of each year until 2030, the date which, as you recall, we set the global to reduce CO2 by 45% in comparison to today. So basically, the UN, by 2030, we have to, all right, so I guess we pretty much have to invest in reducing CO2 emissions. I'll have to definitely look into that. Prime Minister, several countries have already instituted a carbon tax, and their carbon dioxide emission is proven to be deterrent, and more importantly, can be reinvested into the ecological transition. Globally, it is successful in curbing those emissions that are responsible for a significant portion of rising temperatures. I would suggest that we also implement it so that we too play a role in building a new world sustainable for us all. Yay! Now, what if we want all our children to, you know, breathe in the lovely smog? You know, it's so beautiful, and so gray, and so dirty. You got time for that clean energy crap? Alright, so, down here, we have our indexes. You can see there's quite a lot. This is a very micromanageable, intense game. I can expand it and look at all this. It's a lot of shit to manage. Strategic map? Okay. That's pretty cool. It shows us a little overview. So, again, like I say, the United States really likes this. Looks like Britain likes this. Poland really likes this. And South Korea really likes this. So, that's good. We can get some pretty good trades out of that. So, the first thing I want to do, of course, is not so much the budget. I want to take a look at my debt. We are $9.9 billion in deficit. So that's not a good start. And our public debt is at 61%, so we definitely got to start lowering this. Our deficit, though, is only 2.7, which is not bad. It is not bad at all. Which means we're only a 2% deficit, so we can, for saying what we do is not the police. We don't want to cut the police, but we can adjustments in our Secret Service. For starters, we don't need all these agents. Egypt, yeah, we'll need. Basically, I'm going to just have them in our closest hostile hotspots. So we don't need Malaysia, Mexico, Nigeria. We don't need all this crap. We're just going to go ahead and lower that down, lower it down, lower it down. Pakistan, don't need you. Saudi Arabia. But you know what, maybe we'll leave some in Saudi Arabia. Because they are pretty close. So we'll get 30 agents in Saudi Arabia. Your priority goals are political spying. And same for everything. I'm pretty much going to do that for everything. Alright, create. We're going to put 20. I want to put 20 in Syria. If I can find a damn thing. Syria, Syria, Syria. Where are you, Syria? There you are. And 20. Confirm. Oh, that's right, it'll take a while for to get it back. Manage networks. Create a network of agents. So we got Syria, I want Lebanon. Where are you, JK? Oh, there it is, Lebanon. Let's get 20 agents in there. Jordan's pretty neutral to us, so let's go Palestine. Remember, select the country first, then you know. Alright, let's let that run for a minute. So okay, so let's see here. We've got terrorists. These guys. Alright, budget. Special international agents, so we used about what, 150? So we can drop that down to about 152. And crypto. I wanna. Ooh. Hey, budget economy. 3 million. Oh, we can drop counterintelligence a little bit. We can actually reduce our number of agents that we actually have. Yeah, that frees up some. Some budget costs. Okay, so. We'll have about 800 agents internally. Bump up the cyber analyst. Okay, there. 200. Or 209. Even by doing that, we freed up $20 million, so that's a very good start. Cybersecurity. Launch a cyber protection program for administrations and infrastructure. Launch a massive cyber attack. No. Citizen awareness of cybersecurity. This awareness campaign takes place in a marketing campaign to inform the globals. habits. This will cost $3 million. It's not bad. Okay. And this is 154 million over 5 years, but we get reimbursed. Oh yeah, Jimbo. Costs over 5 years, annual reimbursement 300 to reach construction objective. Broad cyber detection training sessions to educate public service staff. Usage of secure messages for all personnel. Silver cyber protection is the following. Everything mandatory cyber security audit for state services and administration mandatory degree. Costs over 5 years, $1.54 billion annual reimbursement. So I get $309 million back. But that's still just the same as that. So it's kind of like you get your money back over course of 5 years. So $309 million a year. We'll wait on that. Alright, let's go take a look at other meeting. This is the meeting. Oh. Oh, so you want to sell me some shit. You want me to pay $86 million for cereals. When my national... Yeah, I'm just gonna refuse. Sorry, dude. But I will sell you something. Let's see here, what can I sell you? About some apples. No, nope, you don't want apples. No. About, I heard they're good with flowers. Okay. All right. I'm not sure if we can sell anything. Bananas? Some bananas? Beef? No. Bottled water. Okay, just cancel the meeting. Yay! Clean cars. In order to address the public health problems linked to air pollution, especially in our cities, responsible for CO2 emissions, yada, etc., etc. File of terrorist suspects. CO2, carbon tax. Alright. Indoctrine disruptors. No more delays. My god, everybody's gone green. No more delays. Organic. Clean cars. Dear god, people, I can only do so much. Okay. So, taxation. You guys want me to create a tax on carbon emissions. That's the highest we can. 5%. And how much? People are neutral about it. It would definitely pass through legislation, so. Thank you. are still neutral. Most of my party would be against it, so that would not go out. How about 15? We drop this down to 15%. Okay, that would pass. Can we go higher? Maybe what about 18? We would be kind of neutral on it. All right, let's try for 18. Parliament's for it, 54%, so it should pass. This is a new reform. Parliament tax law. Confirm. All right, let's create it. That's going to give us 281. So that's pretty good at lowering our deficit. Let's go ahead and get the clock running on that. We gotta start setting up some meetings with the. So let's go ahead and get that out of the way. Meeting request with Mr. Ronald Trump. Yeah, I think we all know who that is. And now Canada. Cars, organic. Okay, I will take a look at that. If I setting you an example. Since I believe in what there are difficult times for me, you should show your solidarity by decreasing your salary if you want to be a model nation for this blah 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 blah. Yes, in due time, my friends, in due time. Secret Service, I'm assuming. Interior. Place a person under surveillance. Parties. Terrorist. File on these guys. Place these guys under surveillance. Hopefully we might be able to arrest some of them. That's the subsidize. No. Water treatment. How much is that? Holy crap, that's expensive. Combat noise pollution, earthquake, nuclear threats, forest fires, construction, legislation. How are you doing? No. CO2 emissions. Here, see, it's already decreasing. Dropped one. Dropping. Now, let's see here. Health? Yeah, health is pretty good for right now. But they care so much about the environment. Setting an example. Yeah, no, I'm not lowering my salary just yet. Hyperloop, let's get this train started. Clean cars. So energy, linked to air pollution, we should have the development of electric cars while our sustainable lower than more premature deaths. However, under our environmental program and with our electricity production relying heavily on fossil fuel, these vehicles will still be incredibly responsible for CO2 emissions. So we gotta change our energy production. Construction. How much would it be to build a solar? $1,248,002,000. T-watts, I don't know if that's terawatts. Cost over 5 years, 1.2. Hydroelectricity on shoreline. More expensive. Offshore wind. Right now. I mean, come on, we're like in the Middle East, we're directly on the effing equator, of course it's gonna be good. Isn't there a spot where it can be very good? Good everywhere, I'm assuming. Alright, well, we'll go ahead and start building one. Alrighty, so get one solar. We'll get some of that money back once we okay. Okay, so apparently they found some shit out. Where's the ground? You see their file. Apparently monitoring. Okay. As for right now, we're just going to wait for those meetings to happen, and then I will go ahead and call it an episode. There's one. There we go. Alright, I want to sell you stuff. Yes, you will buy apples for $92 million. Let's go 9, 27. Let's go ahead and sign in. No, you're not gonna low ball me, dude. How about 793? All right, that got me 80 million. In the meeting. Just gotta wait for the next one. Intelligence. All right, getting some more intelligence reports. Hello, Canada. All right, I will. But first, buy my shit. Okay, 39 million. I don't think I'm gonna get much for these. Alright, 12? Nope. Damn. 693. Okay. It's another 6 million. That's good. Meaning, intelligence. Twice in one day. Browse sites with sexual content. Gone to the baker's twice in one day. Took a bicycle ride near a school. Alright, well, they haven't really. Well, thank you. I would like to set up a meeting with you then to speak highly of me in public. Russia has just created a new space program, and don't give a shit about Russia. Yay! Can I sell? I know I can sell flowers. No, we can't. Fish? Nope. Oh dear lord. Kind of running low on apples here. Banana? No. Beef? No. I have to go through the whole clickeroo. Ooh, nice. You can sell wood. National production. National. Okay, so wood is definitely a big money maker for us. About 116. Come on. Ooh, that's a good deal. 362,609. That is a very, very good deal. Yeah, we're not going to go through space program. Nice taxes. Prime Minister, I would like you to direct your attention to the potential gold mine for the state that tends to be neglected. Taxes on the highway system has the advantage of being less head-on than a direct levy to allow the development of other transportation infrastructure. With the funds collected and can be environmental friendly, we should accept some resistance from commuters. Ultimately, it's still taxation that's weighing gold. So, tax the highway system. He wants me to do. China discovers the self-fragment fiber. That's just letting me know my guys are encouraged development of electric cars. I will suggest Prime Minister progressively raising the tax on petroleum products. Just like tobacco, this will undoubtedly yield results in the long term and while filling the state's coffers. Now you guys can't even wait for me to build my damn solar plant, can you? Well, I could have 10 of these built in 10 years. So by 2029, we'll be fully on solar. Offer you a coffee. You are radiant. I want you to... It will make me very happy, so thank you. Friend for our world. See, the colleges love me. Statement in the press. Ooh, booyah there. 54%. Alright. Alright. Prime Minister, a video of a woman being followed by a hidden camera in the streets of our capital and circulating on the internet, whistling the comments and the aggressive verbal imprisonment that she has endured in the streets of harassment on the street. In reality, very few nations have passed law, you know, changing attitudes and make your mark by making great strides in the issue of equality. I remind you that one voter out of two is a woman. Association for Women's Rights. Alright, we got a meeting with, Poland wants to make an appointment with us. Yeah. I could do better. I know. I'm still new at this. Give me a break. Public finances is going up. Uh-oh. Ooh. Arrest all of them. For coffee. Can I sell you anything? No. Oh, that's right. Yeah, we have. Do you want wood? Can I give you some wood? No, actually. You. Well. Oh, we're already selling you, apparently. We don't have, well, look at it, production 19, oh, consumption, yeah, you're good on wood, so you don't need that. How about tea? I'll sell you a little bit of tea. For 1 million? Oh, that's not really much of anything. Ooh, hello, 1,276 million dollars for pharmaceuticals. Now we're talking. Average sale price. Price here, go 112 cents. Take 109. They'll take 109. I'll take it. That's a good trade agreement right there. That is a beauty. Carbon-based biodegradable plastic. Good for China. I should go send some agents over there and steal their shit. Okay, with that being said, I'm going to call this an episode. Thank you all so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. I will be sure to see you all in the next one. Oh, wait. And on that note... this happen? Troubles in Jerusalem. Yeah, well. Yeah, you would do this right when I want to call a freaking episode. You sons of biscuits. Alright. I want you to bring in police reinforcements. So, trouble in Jerusalem, relief enforcement have arrived. Alright, well, like I said, I'm going to call it an episode. We will deal with this uprising on the next one. And have a good day, everyone. I will see you all later.